Hey everyone, welcome to Oil Life. We are here doing our normal DIY Tuesday video. My name is Sarah.
I'm Emily.
And we're here to talk a little bit more about making perfumes today.
Perfume.
Yes, it's fun. So if you've ever made perfumes before, definitely let us know in the comments you've had, because we are fairly new to this, and so
we're not experts.
We're not experts about this. But we have gotten some great tips and tricks, and we want to let you in on that as well, so you can make your own perfumes at home.
Yeah.
So before we get going, we do our normal giveaway, right? Today's giveaway is awesome. I'm actually so stoked about it. We will be giving away one of our perfume bottles. You can choose which one you want to receive. So we've got three awesome vintage perfume bottles here. They're super cute. All you have to do is share our video to be entered to win that. And every 200 shares, we'll give away another bottle. Yeah. So share it, get your friends, get your family to share it, and we will keep giving out bottles the more shares that
we
get.
So the first bottle, will we give it away regardless of shares?
Yes.
Okay, so the first bottle comes from comments, so make sure you're sharing.
Shares and comments,
you know about perfume.
But for additional shares, we will give away more perfume
bottles. Okay, awesome.
Yeah.
So share this video.
Share the video. It's going to be great. So first things first.
We're going to start with some tips.
We are.
Right? We're going to go over four tips.
Yes.
Our first one is kind of the recipe for making perfumes. So it starts with the idea that essential oils have different notes to them, and there's three different types of notes. There's base notes, middle notes, and top notes, as well as classifications that oils kind of fall into. And so making a perfume recipe is really based off of that. There's no necessarily wrong or right way to do it, but this is the best practice for it. So it's really cool because a new addition to the Essential Life 4th edition, which is this big book over here, but I'm using the little one, which also has all that same information, is this awesome section in it called the classification section. And so in it, it shows the different classifications in which oils fall into which. And so like citrus, floral, spice, herbs, roots, and wood. There's also resins and leaves, but we'll stay on these ones. Just for simplicity's sake. So top notes are typically your citrus. They can also be your floral.
It's kind of convenient that they're laid out this way.
Yeah. So citrus are always top notes. Floral and herbs can be top notes. They can also be middle notes.
Right.
And then your spices, roots and woods are all base notes. There's a little bit of variance, I believe, in the spices. Some spices can also be middles. So this page, these three kind of go between. But that's kind of a quick way to kind of see which ones are top, middle, and base, but then also kind of pick a theme. So you want more of a florally scent, or woodsy, or minty.
Right where to start.
And so you know where to start and which ones pair nicely, which you can also find throughout the Essential Life, what oils pair nicely with what. So a few ideas about what a base might be would be like patchouli, myrrh, vetiver, like any of your heavy woods, those oils that come out really thick. Middles would be, what do we got? Juniper berry, rose, lavender. Lavender's a huge middle.
Popular one.
And then top notes again.
Lime and
all those citruses. A couple of the herbs, so thyme, basil.
Right.
As well as like some of the leafy ones like peppermint, would be top notes.
Definitely.
So that's the first tip.
Okay, so moving on, number two. We recommend that when you are mixing your oils in your bottle, or whichever size of bottle you choose to mix it in, we recommend to get the scent that you want and to get that final scent, make sure you're mixing them around and then let it sit in a dark place for a couple days, we recommend. So that you can see what they all smell like when they really meld together. Because it might produce a different smell once they're all kind of combined. So we recommend before you just spray it all over the place and wear it every day, let it sit for a couple days and see how it turns out, because that probably will change how it smells.
Right, and you can always do it in our little sample vials, so that way you can probably have a couple different blends going on.
And then make
smell
them
and see how it changes, and then expand on it, add your carrier oil, etc.
Right.
So that way you're not necessarily filling up your fancy bottles to begin
with.
Definitely. So that's a great idea.
Okay.
And then number three is that often the recipes for perfumes suggest that you mix in alcohol. Alcohol helps preserve the essential oils, and it also helps to enhance the aromas,
right,
the smells. And so that's typically, if you look up perfume recipes, it'll suggest alcohol. But a common substitute for alcohol, just for various reasons, a lot of people don't like to use alcohol, is witch hazel. And so you'll often find that recipes call for witch hazel, and that's why. It's that preservative, that enhancer.
Definitely.
So you'll want to make sure that you pick up some of that. We do sell that here at Oil Life. You can also get it in your general store,
right,
as well. So
the link is in our description. So, and the link for all the products that you always see in any of our videos, all you have to do is click on this video's description and you'll be able to purchase those.
Yeah.
Easy to find.
Number four.
Sometimes your bottles might have harder openings, things like that.
Especially if you get into the fancy perfume,
yes,
bottles.
Yes. You'll see when I start to make my perfume later, some of the closures are going to be a little bit smaller. So we've got a lot of different tools that can help you be successful when pouring your oils, when pouring your carrier oils, all,
yeah,
sorts of things like that, because we know it does get messy, so we're here to kind of help prevent the mess, right?
Yep.
So one thing that I really like is these pipettes. I think these are the 1 mL pipettes that we have right here. And they're really nice for dispensing carrier oil, or if you want to do it right out of your oil bottles, you can do that as well.
Yeah.
It's a good way to not waste any oils, things like that. We also have a funnel. We have our cute mini funnels. You guys have seen these before.
Fit perfect in a 10 mil roller.
They totally do. So these are really, really fun if you have a hole big enough to
fit it in,
fit the funnel in. These are really easy for putting oils or putting your carrier oil through when making your perfumes. And
so now we're going to talk about bottles.
Yeah.
We're going to talk about all the different bottles. So be watching, because we're going to ask you what your favorite is.
Yes.
So in the back, we just have some of our 4-ounce spray bottles.
Yes.
These are typical pump spray. If I can get the cap off. So just your typical pump spray.
We
have a variety. Don't forget about ombres. Oh, we have 2 ombres here.
Yes, we have 2.
And then also we have a variety of other colors in the classic amber and cobalt, and then the green and clear. So this is a good size to make a perfume out of.
Totally.
And
you can put labels on these as well, which is
oh,
nice,
yeah,
because they do
some
have
that
flat
edge
on them, so it's
going
to accommodate a label better than some of our other
ones. And then we also have these awesome misters, like the thin cylinder misters. These are great for breast sprays, but also perfumes, just to kind of throw in your purse, so it's
right,
not quite as heavy or glass.
Definitely.
Like the 4-ounce bottles. So more for that kind of on the go in your purse, carry with you all the time. And then we wanted to talk about real quick that you can also make perfumes in roller bottles.
Definitely.
Obviously it's a smaller size, and you wouldn't use witch hazel, you just another carrier oil,
substitute
like fractionated
it.
Coconut oil, almond oil, avocado oil, jojoba oil, which we sell all of those. So that's what you'd use in a roller bottle. Those are great for not only perfumes, but also colognes.
Definitely.
Which we're not talking about today, but colognes, that's better for a man than
a spray.
Oh, for
sure, a roller might be
mm-hmm.
easier.
And so then we have our perfume bottles, which is what we're highlighting today,
totally,
and which we're giving away. So again, make sure you're commenting, asking us questions, telling us perfumes you've made.
Which one of these 3 is your favorite? Because
yeah,
we'll tell you which are ours.
So this is obviously a clear bottle, pink. What do you call this? I just call it
a
squeezer.
Like a pump?
Pump!
A pump?
Yeah, so a pump. And then we have this kind of more vintage, rustic kind of feel. We also have this in ribbed glass. We don't have any more in the store, so we can't show it. We do have them online.
Definitely.
So again, that's just with this push-down pump. And then
my personal favorite,
fancy
I love this
blue
one.
Bottle with this longer kind of cord. This reminds me of the Western days.
Yes, I love it.
Put it on your nightstand or your
I think
your
these
vanity.
Are really
vanity,
cute.
That's what it's called.
Totally. They're fit for a vanity. They look great.
So yeah, tell us
yeah.
in the comments, which of these 3 are your favorite perfume misters?
This
that you
one
would
is
love.
Mine.
And this one's mine. So we're going to make
perfume. We're going to make some. We're going to show you. The thing I will say before we make our perfumes is you can try out all different types of oils. You don't have to do the specific recipes that we are doing. We're just trying out ones that we are interested in.
Yeah.
So as we said, with the Essential Life Book, you can create your own by looking at, you know, those base, middle, and
what
top
aromas
notes.
Speak to you.
Definitely.
If you want to get even more in depth what aromas actually might help with some physical or
for
emotional
sure.
needs. So.
For sure. And so if you already are into making essential oil perfumes, let us know what have you made, what
yeah.
what smells,
what aromas you like
definitely.
To mix.
So we will start making ours. So mine is more of a woodsy smell.
Mine's more like top note, really light.
Okay.
I like light things.
Yes.
Delicate.
Totally.
Like my bottle.
So what are you starting with?
I'm starting with wild orange or orange.
Okay.
And I'm gonna put 10 drops.
You're gonna drop it right in.
I'm gonna drop it right in because the hole on my bottle is big enough that I can do that. So
I'm gonna drop mine in as well, but if I wanted to, I could actually remove the
orifice reducer. Guys, I don't say that right, but you know what I'm talking about.
And I could use one of our great pipettes to just drop them right in. But I personally am just going to drop it right in. We're gonna try it. We're gonna see how it goes. I'll let you know. So I'm going to do 8 drops of cypress.
And then I'm adding another oil. I'm adding cedar wood, and I'm doing 5 drops.
Okay.
Typically, the ratio, these recipes aren't to the best practice ratio, but typically the ratio is you're going to add more of your middle note than of the other two. Just because the middle note is kind of the heart of the perfume.
Okay, now I'm going with fir. I'm doing Douglas fir. I'm dropping in 4 drops. 1, 2, 3.
Cedarwood's so slow and I can't remember, so this might be 6 drops, but that's okay. I like the smell of cedarwood. Hey, give me a shout out in the comments if you like the smell of cedarwood, because all of my office mates, coworkers, don't like it. So if you like it, let me know.
I'm putting in cedarwood as well. I'm putting in 4 drops of cedarwood.
And then I'm going to put in 3 drops of spearmint. The recipe I found online calls for peppermint, but I don't particularly like the smell of peppermint, so spearmint's always my go-to substitution.
Now I'm going with vetiver, and I'm doing 2 drops. Hopefully we're not mixing you guys up with our 2 different recipes going on right now.
I put an extra drop. Man. So I put 2 drops of rosemary, but I actually put 3. Oh, I like that. There's a lot of wild orange. Wild orange is my favorite. Okay, so I'm gonna just grab the funnel here. The funnel actually does fit into my bottle, so I'm gonna use the funnel there, and I'm gonna pour in some witch hazel. I can move that out of the camera's way a little bit, I guess. See how good I can do this. And we're just gonna fill this bottle up. So another question you might be asking is the ratio of oils to the how big the bottle is. So these bottles are about 4 ounces,
mm-hmm.
which is about 120 milliliters.
I'm finishing up with 2 drops bergamot. I'm a little bit slower. I'm coming.
No, you're fine. So, I need the funnel. I almost just poured that all over. Did you guys see that? Okay. So I'm only gonna fill this halfway because I feel like for the how big the bottle is, I probably should have doubled my oils. I really am spilling that everywhere. So I just filled it up about halfway so that it is the right ratio with my oils.
Right.
And then I'm gonna put the top on. But you're gonna fill yours with witch hazel now, right?
Yes, yes I am.
And what's wrong with your bottle?
My bottle.
Not wrong with it. What's different about your bottle?
If you can see it. It is a really, really small hole. So me trying to pour witch hazel through that teeny little hole is
even with
probably
the funnel,
a bad
right?
idea.
The funnel.
Even the funnel. The funnel,
the
doesn't,
funnel doesn't
quite
fit.
Oops.
The funnel doesn't
We're
fit.
All over the place. So I'm gonna use the pipette again. These are the best. So what I would just recommend doing: put it in a bowl, put your witch hazel in a bowl, and then you can fill it accordingly. This is gonna make it a little bit easier to get it in, because that hole is teeny. And then I can just do it easily. Might take a little bit longer, but it's worth it.
What's your favorite essential oil aroma, Sarah?
My favorite? I love all of the woodsy smells. I love them.
You do? Is that why you love dashing through the
pines? There's
through the
a
pines.
There is a it's one of the 12 sprays of Christmas sprays, and I keep it by my desk, and I think I smell it a couple times a day. I don't know if that's embarrassing or not, but
No, it's a great spray.
It's
so
a
you love
spray.
The woodsies.
I love the woodsies. Yeah. So this was like super perfect.
That was a perfect blend for you. Yeah.
Exactly. Cause this is my kind of stuff. That's probably what makes me so excited for Christmas. Is I love the smell of like pine trees, and you know Christmas trees in your living room, that kind of a thing.
Awesome. So make sure you're telling us in the comments. We want to know what your favorite aroma is as well. Definitely. I mean, mine's wild orange and hers is woods.
All the woodsy smells.
All the woods. So let us know. Again, let us know if you have experience making perfumes, what kinds of bottles you use, what kind of recipes you use. We're just going to go through the tips real quick once again. So a basic recipe for perfume making is top, middle, base notes, which is kind of classifications of oils. So they're what note category they fit into. The ratio of those is usually that your middle note is about 50% of your blend. Also the classifications, I took my sticky nose up. You can find in the Essential Life fourth edition, you can find in the Essential Basics. This will tell you what oils fit under what classification. It also helps you with the top, middle, and base, because citrus are always top, floral and herbs can be both middle and top, spices can be middle or base, and then we have our roots and woods down here that can be bases. So that's just a quick reference for that. Then mixing it in advance.
So I probably won't use this for a couple days because I want it to know. I want to know what it's going to smell like when all of them finally.
Yeah. So we'll shake them, right? Stir them.
We'll shake
them
a little
bit.
And then
let them sit for a little before we use them.
Could put them in like a dark cabinet or something like that so they stay dark.
And then you can also experiment with and use vials to kind of experiment with different aromas and mixtures, and do the same thing and let them sit in the vials. And then witch hazel.
Yep.
Witch hazel is the go-to addition to perfumes. You don't want to add water. In most perfume recipes, it's alcohol, and witch hazel is the amazing substitute for alcohol.
Definitely.
And then last, dispensing tools. So you'll want to make sure you have some kind of tiny funnel and some pipettes.
We sell both of these, by the way.
We have other dispensing tools on the website as well. So we have all the needs that you might, all the things you might need.
Definitely.
So yeah, make sure that you're sharing.
Share it. Share it so that you can be entered to win one of these awesome perfume bottles.
Yeah.
So we will be giving away one for sure, and then for every additional 200 shares, we'll be giving away more bottles.
Another bottle.
Yep. Another bottle. So share this. Share with your friends. Maybe tag someone that might be interested in getting started with perfume making, because.
Yeah.
I think this is super fun, and it's a great gift as well. So
it was fun to learn about too.
Oh, definitely.
It's like a science.
So this might be a fun Christmas gift or something like that.
Could you imagine this as a Christmas gift?
I would love that. It would be pretty.
So thank you for joining us.
Yes.
We will see you on Friday.
See you Friday.